Hello children, welcome you all in today's class. In today's class, we'll be discussing the homework answers which were given in the previous class. And along with that, we will see few more concepts from the chapter. Can you see the patterns? Okay. So, see the question number H140. So, this was the question that was given. Okay, you have to mention the rule and you have to complete the pattern. Okay. So, can you see here? First time, the symbol, the diamond shaped symbol is down. Next it goes to the left side, next it goes to the top, and next again it will come to the right. Okay, so in this blank you will draw the circle. Okay, and then at the right side you will draw the diamond shape, and the shaded part will be on the top. Can you see here? The shaded part is down, right? So here it will be on the top. Okay, so what will be the next one? It will come down. So again we are reaching the same figure that we started with. Clear? So what is the rule used here? 1/4 turn clockwise. So it is moving towards this side only, no? So that is clockwise direction only. Okay, so right, 1/4 turn clockwise. Okay, coming to the next question, here we are starting with the P and we are giving 45 degree turn, and again we have to end with this shape. Okay, so here after this, after giving 45 degree, it will look in this way. Okay, next after that, next Okay, next. And then at last you will reach the figure that you have started with. Okay, so how many figures you have completed here? Starting from this, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. So the 8th figure after the first figure looks the same. Is it clear? So here we are using the 45 degree rule. Now look at page number 102. So here we have a purple colored triangle on the top, then it is moved 45 degree, then it is again moving 45 degree and facing towards the right side. Then after moving 45 degree, how it will look? Will it again go to the top, violet color? No, it will come down. Okay, so this is the correct figure that comes next. So what is the rule used? It is 45 degree turn clockwise. Okay, in clockwise direction only it's moving, right? Okay. Next one, here the purple color triangle is on the top, then it comes to the down, then it goes to the left side, then after that it should come up. Okay, so where is it? So here you have purple color and here you have purple color. Okay, so out of these two, which is correct? Yes, first one is the correct one. Okay, so again here what is the rule followed? It is 1/4 turn in clockwise direction. Next question, this is a figure given and we have to find which figure will come next. Okay, so first this figure is facing like this, then it will face this way, then it will face, if you turn this like this, then also it is going to face the same as the first figure. Okay, next again if you are turning it, then again it will look as the same as the second figure. Okay, so here this one, and the rule followed is again 1/4 turn clockwise. Is it clear for all of you? Next is H145. So here we have some umbrellas. Okay, on page number 103. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, So is it correct? See, first it is facing the right side, then it is facing down, okay, then it is facing left, then it is facing up, then it is facing right, then again after right it should face downward direction, but it is facing upward direction. Okay, so the correct diagram is to face downward. Can you see here, after right side the umbrella is facing downwards, the next umbrella is facing towards the leftwards, okay, but this umbrella only is wrong. Next, so here we have a four side polygon and a circle and a triangle. Okay, next is a triangle, a circle and a four sided polygon. Let us name this to be some square. Next, this one as this one looks similar to this one, okay, but what about this? No, here we have circle outside and the quadrilateral shape inside, but here we have a quadrilateral shape outside and the circle shape inside. Okay, so both these are totally different. Okay, so here instead of this quadrilateral you should get circle, and instead of the circle you should get quadrilateral. Understood for all of you?
Now let us look at the next question. H147. We have to fill the given square with the numbers from 46 to 54 such that each line, each row and each column should give the sum of 150. Okay. Now this is row 1, row 2, row 3, column 1, column 2 and column 3. Okay. So in out of these, which is having two numbers? In row 1, only one number. In row 2, only one number. In row 3, two numbers we have. Okay. So we can start with R3. Okay. We have to subtract it from 150. So add this to 52 plus 47. Clear? So that is nothing but 150 minus 99. And that is how much? 150 minus 99. 51. Okay. Clear? So we have the numbers 46, 47, 48, 49, 50, 51, 52, 53 and 54. So here already we have 46. We have 47, then we have 49, then we have 51, then 52. Okay. Okay, now C1 is having two numbers. So we can start with C1 now. So 150 minus 46 plus 51. Okay, and that is 150 minus 97. Okay, and that is equal to how much? 53. Clear? So 53 gets cancelled. Now R1 is having two numbers. So start with R1. 150 minus 53 plus 49. Okay, and that is equal to 150 minus 3 plus 9, 12. And 5, this is 10, 1 or 2. And how much is that? 10 minus 2, 8. And 4 minus 10, 14 minus 10 is 4, 48. Clear? Now either you can take C2 or C3. We'll go one by one. C2. 150 minus 48 plus 52. And that is 150 minus 100. that is 50. Okay. So obviously, what number will you have here? 54. Understood? You can even check and see. C3, 150 minus 49 and 47. That is 150 minus 9 plus 7, 16. 4 plus 4, 8 plus 1, 9, 96. And that is 54. Okay. So is it clear? So this is how you will fill this magic square. Okay, children, look at the next question. Fill the square with numbers from 1 to 9 such that each line has sum of 15. Okay. Now here, in R2 and C2, we have two numbers. Let us start with C2. Even you can start with R2 also. Okay. So 15 minus, total sum is 15, right? 5 plus 1. And that is 15 minus 6, that is 9. Okay. So here you will have 9. Next, go with R1. In R1, 15 minus 4 plus 9, that is 15 minus 13, that is 2. So here you will have 2. Next, R2, 15 minus 5 plus 7, that is 15 minus 12, and that is 3. Okay? Clear? Next, this line is left out. But here we don't have two numbers. But in C1, we have two numbers. So you can take C1. 15 minus 4 plus 3, that is 15 minus 7, that is 8. Okay? So what is left out? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 is not there, 7 is there, 8 is there, 9 is there. So here obviously you will have 6. You can even check it with R3 or C3. Okay? 15 minus 2 plus 7. That is 15 minus 9, and that is nothing but 6. So is it clear? Very easy to solve magic square. Now let us discuss the answer of B1 to B7. So look here, 5 into how much should give you 65? It should be, you all should be thorough with the tables 1 to 15. Okay? So here, 5 13s are 65. Okay? If you know 13 table, it is very easy. Otherwise, you do one thing. Here, 5 is multiplied with some number, right? Yes. And you get the answer as 65. So, you divide 65 by 5. What will you get? 5 ones are 5. 1 remaining. 5 going down. 3s are 15. Okay? So, 13 is the answer. Okay? It's 64 divided by 4. 4 ones are 4, 2 remaining, bring down 4, okay, so 4, 6 are 24, okay, the answer is 16. Next, 108 divided by something is 9, nothing but 12, you all know 12 table, right, 12 nines are 108, right, yes, okay, then 70 into 7, 7 sevens are 49, 7 ones are 7, 7 plus 4, 11, okay. Then 14 and 70 you have to divide. Okay. So listen here. 70 divided by 14. Now you can cancel 14 and 70 in 7 table. 7 2s are 14 and 7 10s are 70. Again cancel 2 1s are 2 and 2 5s are 10. So the finally you have 5 in the numerator and 1 in the denominator. So that is nothing but 5. Okay. So instead of doing this division, you can cancel out and do division like this also. Okay. Then 260 divided by what will give you 26. See, 100 divided by dash is equal to 10. 10, right? Yes. Any number, if it is divided by 10, then 10 from the number will get cancelled. So the same way here, 260 is there. We have to divide by some number so that the 10 here is getting cancelled. That is nothing but 10. So here if you divide by 10, 0 will get cancelled and get the final answer as 26. Okay. Next, 52 into dash will give you 104. So here, see, check 52 is here. Okay, if you put 1 here, 52 ones are 52. Okay, if you put 2 here, what will you get? 2 twos are 4. And 2 fives are 10, 10 plus 1. 2 twos are 4. Okay, then 2 fives are 10. Okay, so 104. So here you should have 2. So only then you will get the answer as 104. Okay, so think over it and fill in the blanks.
Next, coming to page number 105, here 14 is given and on the right hand side 34 and 20 is given. So you have a star shape here, then you have a rectangle shape, and then you have a circle shape. Now I can write here a circle, I can draw, and I can write here 20, and I can draw a square here with 34. Okay, next, coming to this one, only 42 is given. So this side you will write 65, then 80, okay. So on the right hand side you have a blank in the middle, so here you will have 42. Okay, next, here you have 200 and then 300. So 200 and then you have a shape like this with 300 inside it.
So now let us enter into today's class. So in today's class we will be learning about magic hexagon. Okay, so hexagon has 6 sides. Okay, and in this hexagon you can see circles and you can see boxes. Okay, and one more thing, the rule followed in magic square was all the lines should give the particular sum, same sum. And rule followed in magic hexagon is you should multiply the numbers in the circles and you have to write the number, write the product in the box in between those two circles. For example, 9 elevens are 99. Clear? Now, 11 sixes are 66. Okay? And 6 into 17 is how much? See, 17 into 6. 6 sevens are 42. 6 ones are 6. 6 plus 4, 1. 10, 10, 10. So, 102. Okay? Next, 17 into 7 is there. So, 17 into 7. 7 sevens are 49. 7 ones are 7, 7 plus 4, 11. So 119. Okay. Then here we don't have anything. And here also we don't have anything. So first you have to find a number such that when you multiply it with 9, you get 108. Just now we saw in the homework, right? So when you multiply 12 with 9, you will get 108. Okay. Now 7 into 12 is how much? 80. 4. Okay, is it clear? So now all the boxes and all the circles are filled. So only one rule followed is the product of circles is written in the box in between them. Fine. So using this rule you will complete the magic hexagon. Go through the video properly and try to understand everything that is taught. Thank you and have a nice day.